Hi, it's DeWire, gamblersadvisory.com, wirevip.com. Look us up in the sports section on Roku. We're there. DeWire Boxing and Sports News. Write the vanity code if you want to add it on the Roku site is one word, DeWire Boxing News. On iTunes, same thing, one word, DeWire Boxing News. Remember, the opinion you should follow should be your own. Just consider this video to be a second opinion from a complete stranger online. Now, there is a great article on BoxingScene.com this morning. I'm going to get to the Klitschko-Pulev fight, but this article dovetails into my analysis there. It's an article in which they're interviewing Sergey Kovalev's trainer, John David Jackson. Right now, keep in mind, Jackson's a former champion who used to spar with Bernard Hopkins when Hopkins was the up-and-coming fighter, and of course Jackson later fought Hopkins in the ring. Jackson even was involved in Hopkins' corner for more than one fight. Right? Now, Jackson lays out what he believes to be the blueprint to beat Floyd Mayweather. He says it's the same blueprint that his fighter used against Bernard Hopkins. Right? For the boxing historians out there, it's Rocky Marciano's philosophy to fighting. In other words, the other guy covers up. You come in, you hit the guy on the arms, right? You're not wasting a lot of time going headhunting. You're hitting the guy wherever he is. The idea is that if I hit this bicep enough times, you won't be able to use this arm later in the fight. Also, the judges will see that I'm the one pushing the action. I'm the lead puncher, right? Marciano was the lead puncher, and I'll be the one piling up points. Right, so John David Jackson believes that if you're fighting Floyd Mayweather, forget about his hair. You want to come in, you want to touch his body, you want to touch his arms. Jackson goes further and says you even want to be a little illegal. Right, depending on where the ref is in the ring, depending on what you can get away with, you even want to try some illegal punches. Right, read the article speaks for itself. Right, an argument can be made that this is what Marcus Maidana was attempting to do in the first fight. I respect John David Jackson quite a bit, but I'm going to disagree. I think if you come up on Floyd Mayweather, I think you're playing into his game. I believe Mayweather is different than Bernard Hopkins. Right, Hopkins is an overachiever. He doesn't have blinding hand speed, right? He never had blinding foot speed. This is a guy who really gets by based on his knowledge of the sport and how hard he works on his craft, right? Hopkins is a guy who lost his first fight, right? So Bernard has studied the sport. He understands he was never a freak athlete. In interviews, he openly talks about how in the first fight against Roy Jones was simply too fast for him. Now understand, Mayweather is the opposite end of the spectrum athletically. Mayweather's a great athlete. Even today, he's a great athlete. His hand speed is a different level than Bernard Hopkins. Months ago, I made a video here online. I encourage everyone to look at it. I think I called it Mayweather Hopkins, Who's Better? Or something like that. Right? The point is simply, Mayweather is the guy who can throw the 100 mile an hour fastball, who also knows how to pitch. Okay? Hopkins is the guy who throws, let's say, 92 miles an hour, but who has figured out how to pitch and who has figured out how to camouflage his fastball so he gets you out. I don't believe you can fight the guys the same. Right? I think Mayweather is too fast. Chances are your fighter, unless he's Amir Khan, right? Perhaps Manny Pacquiao, Gary Russell, chances are your fighter is going to have slower hand speed than Floyd Mayweather. Right? Those are the facts of life. Also, Mayweather has a certain dynamic to his game that Hopkins doesn't have to his. Mayweather is exceedingly accurate. What I want you to do is to look at the CompuBox numbers. You're going to find out there are very few people as accurate as Mayweather. So I believe what you have to do, right, I'm going to break from John David Jackson here. What I believe you have to do against Floyd Mayweather is stay outside, use his low volume against him, and then come in and lead with power shots. Right? I've been saying this online for years. Right? I believe guys like Brad Solomon would have a shot on Floyd Mayweather. The idea is you don't box a boxer. Right? Don't play chess with Floyd Mayweather. What you want to do is just be outside. If you're playing chess at all, make it fake chess, where you're hinting at things you don't do. Right? You want to be outside on Mayweather. You want to look for an opening. Then you want to jump in with the power shot. Let's talk about Vladimir Klitschko against Kubrat Pulev. Now, let me say this. The boxing world needs to be afraid. This version of Vladimir Klitschko in his late 30s beats any other version of Vladimir Klitschko. Folks, the heavyweight champion is learning on the job, and right now he is better than ever. Right? Understand, old Klitschko, too robotic. Right? Too cautious. Kept his guard up for several rounds. Would stick you with a jab, didn't have the confidence to drop his hands. Right? Would work into other punches. This Klitschko drops his hands at times. This Klitschko is even dancing at times. There are moments in this Kubrat Pulev fight where he's up on his toes, folks. I've posted the video of the fight in my favorites folder. You need to look at it. Now, let me just say this, too. There was a time where I was online here and I was pointing out that Klitschko really didn't know how to clinch that well. That was years ago. This Klitschko is a master clincher. Master clincher. Right now, the clinching for the skeptics, right? And I'm a skeptic at times. The clinching masks really an inability to fight inside. Even this Klitschko doesn't go to the body often at all. So you're facing a headhunter who really can't fight inside. But the problem is you don't get the opportunity to even try to fight inside, because Klitschko is clinching you. But here's the payoff. In the first round, Klitschko does exactly what I believe an opponent would have to do to beat Floyd Mayweather. Old Klitschko would have to touch you with something before he'd throw a power punch. This Klitschko is higher level. He leans in on Kubrat Pulev after a break, and he throws a hellacious left hook. Folks, Klitschko's left hook is as good a punch as there is in boxing. Right? It's a hellacious, hellacious left hook. It drops Kubrat Pulev. After that punch lands, the first time in the first round, life is different. Right, Pulev hits the canvas. Pulev is embarrassed. What transpires next, for those of you in a profiling personalities, is fascinating. After Pulev gets dropped, Pulev gets up and he wants to convince Vladimir Klitschko that he's not badly injured. So he does something Bernard Hopkins did against Kovalev. He sticks his tongue out. He does something else. He lifts one leg to show that he can balance himself on one leg. He's not doing this for the referee, folks. I want you to look at the tape. He's looking at Vladimir Klitschko. Now, here's what you need to know about Vladimir Klitschko mentally. Vladimir Klitschko has the kind of confidence that can only come from past failure. Vladimir Klitschko has failed in the past, right? He lost to Ross Purity. He's been knocked out. He got stopped by Lehman Brewster. He's been knocked down. He got knocked down multiple times by Sam Peter. So understand, Vladimir Klitschko long ago stopped believing in his invincibility. He's not interested in that. That's wasted energy. That's wasted motion. He's just there to win a fight. If some guy is trying to prove to him that he's not hurt, then Klitschko would know, since he's been around the block, that that guy's badly hurt. Right? Because Klitschko himself has been badly hurt in fights. Right? So, understand, this is almost like a child in Pulev trying to convince his father that he can stay in the game. Klitschko doesn't care about that. Understand what Klitschko does right after that moment. He comes in, throws another power shot, drops Pulev again. Understand how scary Klitschko is. He's been on the world stage long enough where the event is just another event for him. Right? For Kubrat Pulev, this was his big moment. He had to show us that any knockdown of him was a flash knockdown. He had to prove to the champ, hey, I'm here to fight. I'm not going away lightly. For Vladimir Klitschko, this is just another day at the office. You understand that. Right? Klitschko, I believe, knows he could be the person getting knocked down. Right? He's not interested in what Kubrat Pulev thinks. I know this sounds hard, but, you know, I really believe that the guys who have had problems in the ring, who have come back from adversity, who have asked themselves whether they should quit the sport, who have had family members, like his big brother Vitaly, tell him he should quit the sport. A guy who then makes a decision to continue on in the sport. That kind of mental toughness can only come from experience. As you look at the film, understand that a huge part of Klitschko's game, and keep in mind, Klitschko already is one of the best athletes in boxing. Right, as you look at him move, when you see him up on his toes, just understand how tall he is. Just understand he's a heavyweight. Understand he's much bigger physically than, let's say, historical heavyweights like Rocky Marciano or Joe Frazier. He's much bigger physically than David Haye. Right? This is a big man. Look at how he moves. What you'll notice too is that Klitschko now is comfortable enough, he's competent enough to drop his hands. Now think about it. He's here against a great jabber in the heavyweight division. But he reads Pulev pretty early. And he at times is actually able to drop his hands. He's relying on his athleticism. He's trusting his body. Right? I'm not saying today he looks as flashy as Paulie Malignaggi. I'm not saying that. But understand, this is different than the Vladimir Klitschko who was with Emanuel Stewart. Right? Let me just say this. Let's fast forward to the fifth round, right? This is after Pulev has gotten off the canvas multiple times, right? The left hook that Vladimir Klitschko throws in that fifth round to end the fight. And understand, Klitschko's a right-handed fighter. Right? The left hook that he throws in the fifth round is one of the best punches thrown in any fight this year. We talk about fights of the year. Let's talk about punches of the year. It simply cannot be thrown any better than that. Understand, Pulev hits the canvas. He actually leans up off the canvas. Folks, he's finished. His head then drops back to the canvas. There is no way the fight could continue. There is no way Pulev, who had never been stopped before, could have beaten the count. Right? The fight is over. Right? Dare I say, we talk about Hopkins fighting into his late 40s. The rumor is now he's going to continue fighting. Understand, Vladimir Klitschko, in his late 30s, and heavyweights tend to mature later than other weight classes. Right? Just to understand, Vladimir Klitschko in his late 30s has several years left if he wants them. He's physically superior to most heavyweights, right? Just in terms of athleticism in the heavyweight division, I would say only Povetkin, David Haye, possibly Deontay Wilder are on par with him just in terms of an ability to move around the ring. And understand, Wilder doesn't have the skills to do so. Wilder's a one-handed fighter. Right? I have seen more skilled heavyweights. I believe, personally, Tyson Fury is more skilled than Vladimir Klitschko because Tyson Fury actually can fight inside. When Tyson Fury's inside, Tyson Fury isn't there to clinch you. He's raking shots off your body. Also, Tyson Fury is ambidextrous. When you talk about Tyson Fury's jab, you have to talk about which jab. Because he throws a left jab, he throws a right jab. Right? But Tyson Fury, and I know there are photos of him out there looking in great shape, but Tyson Fury isn't the athlete that Vladimir Klitschko is. Right? Vladimir Klitschko can literally just lean and hit you with heavy shots without really overexerting himself. These days, you don't really see Vladimir Klitschko looking tired in the ring. Right? So just from a physical standpoint, just understand that Vladimir Klitschko has several years left if he wants them. Right? He's always been the athlete in his family. He's a better athlete than Vitaly. I still say that if the two men met in the ring, I think Vitaly would win that fight, at least prime Vitaly, not Vitaly today, who has been involved in politics and has been out of, you know, the squared circle for a long time, right? But this really is a bellwether fight. I just want to say that as you look at Vladimir Klitschko, especially early, and as you see him up on his toes, understand this is a guy who literally is still adding things to his game. He's less robotic. He's more fluid. He's leading with power shots. He has one punch knockout capability. He's a better athlete than most, and he has the kind of confidence that can only come from past failure and experience. This fight is one of his finest moments. If you're a Vladimir Klitschko fan, I believe it's a must-see. Let me hear from you. Leave your comments for me here online. Visit us at gamblersadvisory.com. Let me just say this too. I don't believe Deontay Wilder is two-handed enough to pose even a meaningful threat to Vladimir Klitschko. I don't believe Bermain Stiverne moves around the ring well enough to pose a meaningful threat to Vladimir Klitschko. Right? I don't believe the public understands how much of a threat and on his A game, Alexander Povetkin could be to Vladimir Klitschko. Sadly, Povetkin blew it in the first fight. Didn't fight the right fight, kept getting tied up by Vladimir Klitschko, right? And of course, the public's not clamoring for that fight, right? If Tyson Fury doesn't beat Derek Chisora, and I expect Fury to win that fight, but if Fury doesn't beat Derek Chisora, right, and if Fury falls by the wayside, we could be looking at several more years of a Vladimir Klitschko heavyweight title reign, right? David Haye has been out of the ring for a while. David Haye has also had some health issues, right? Rotator cuff issues or what have you. Right, so understand, as I look out on the landscape, I just don't see the meaningful threat to Vladimir Klitschko that's still viable. Right, he can dodge Povetkin and say, look, been there, done that. He could even abdicate some of his titles. Understand, Vladimir Klitschko has several titles. He doesn't have to fight Povetkin again anytime soon because the first fight was one-sided. Right, it's only Tyson Fury. Right, also David Haye, same thing. He can say, I've been there, I've done that. He doesn't have to fight David Haye again. Right, I would argue it's really only Tyson Fury who has a chance at this point. Maybe, let me back up. Maybe Brian Jennings. But Jennings is going to have to show us a bit more ring savvy. Right? I didn't like his last fight that much. Anyway, let me hear from you. Leave your comments for me here online. Visit us at gamblersadvisory.com. Thanks for stopping by.